Our Lord is more merciful than our own mothers upon us. O slave of Allah, if it's not Allah Azza wa Jal whom you desire to please, if it's not Allah Azza wa Jal who you turn to, then where would you go to? Who would look after you and shelter you and aid you and protect you other than Allah Azza wa Jal? We were created in this world for a purpose, for a reason, and that is to know Allah Azza wa Jal. We did not exist in this world except to know Allah Azza wa Jal and to worship Him. Allah Azza wa Jal in His glorious book, He says,
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
And I did not create jinn and mankind except to worship me alone. And how would you be able to worship Allah without knowing Him? How would you be able to fear Allah if you do not know Him? How can you love Allah if you do not know Him? How can you prostrate to Allah if you do not know Him? It's obvious that we are required to know Allah. And this is part of our worship, is to know of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Azza wa Jal, He tells us that if there was any God in the heavens and the earth, it would have been corrupted. He said in His glorious book,
لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا فسبحان الله رب العرش عما يصفون.
If there was any God in the heavens and the earth, it would have been corrupted. The heavens and the earth will be corrupted, it will be destroyed. And the likeness, my brothers, goes to our hearts. Whenever any other than Allah Azza wa Jal is in our hearts, whenever any other than Allah Azza wa Jal is the one whom we love and submit to, we will corrupt and we will be destroyed. Knowing Allah Azza wa Jal is the cause of life for the individual. It's the second birth that every person who believes in Allah will experience. Every person has two births. The birth the day his mother gave birth to him, and the second one is when he knows Allah Azza wa Jal.
أَوَمَنْ كَانَ مَيْتًا فَأَحْيَيْنَا وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُ نُورًا يَمْشِي بِهِ فِي النَّاسِ كَمَنْ مَثَلُهُ فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ لَيْسَ بِخَارِجٍ مِنْهَا.
Is he who was dead without faith by ignorance and disbelief, and we gave him life by knowledge and faith. Allah described the life that was given to this person after he was dead. That happened to him, this life happened to him because of knowledge and faith, and set for him a light of belief whereby he can walk amongst men like him who is in the darkness of disbelief from which he can never come out. Thus is made fair seeming to the disbelievers that which they used to do.
My brothers, there is no doubt that knowing Allah Azza wa Jal is the greatest and most noble of knowledge.
The most noble of knowledge is the knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal. Because when you learn about Allah Azza wa Jal, you're learning about the purpose of your existence. You're learning how to live a life that is in the right course. When you learn about Allah Azza wa Jal and you know Him, you become an individual that explains everything around Him in the light of what Allah has said. He doesn't go on to explain things in any other way. Knowing of Allah Azza wa Jal, in brief and in short, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam is the reason why the Quran was sent down. The Quran was sent down to teach you about Allah Azza wa Jalla, about His names and about His attributes and about His allies, those who worship Him from the prophets and the messengers and their followers, and the result of those who and the end result of those who disbelieve, and the stories of the past. All this is to inform you about Allah Azza wa Jalla. It's all there to teach you about Allah Azza wa Jalla. Knowing Allah Azza wa Jalla has its roots, has its impact on our lives. If a person doesn't know Allah Azza wa Jalla, how can he feed him? How can he love him? This person is someone who can be easily taken away. He'll be no different to that balloon that is thrown out there in the wind. Nothing can hold it down. And the end result of it is it's going to be lost. So knowing about Allah Azza wa Jalla has its fruits and has its effects on every person who has that knowledge.